Now, how does the government ensures that this equality is maintained in the society? So there are two ways to secure equality. First, through the laws. There are certain laws made by the government in the constitution. There are so many laws that says that you cannot discriminate people on the basis of their caste, religion, community, language or gender. They cannot be discriminated. And if someone is found to do so, he will be charged, he will be fined to do so, such thing. He will be given punishment. Second is through government programs and schemes. Now, it is merely not possible through making some laws. Just making some laws is not sufficient. It's not enough. So, there are certain programs, some schemes that are made by the government so that equality can be maintained in practical manner. Practically, we follow such system. So, let us go on the next slide. One of the such scheme is midday meal scheme. I hope you all should be aware of this midday meal scheme. This midday meal scheme, which is nowadays everywhere it is found, in each and every government school it is being practiced. But this was first practiced, introduced in Tamil Nadu in the year 2000. Tamil Nadu was the first state to introduce this scheme. This was the particular scheme which was introduced by Tamil Nadu government. But later on, in 2001, the Supreme Court asked all state governments to begin this program in their schools within 3 months, because it was just such a wonderful program to maintain equality that even the Supreme Court was also agreed to it, and they said, and the Supreme Court ordered all the state governments to practice this midday meal scheme in their schools within 3 months, next 3 months. Now, what is this midday meal scheme? As you all know, in the midday meal scheme, in the government schools, where all the poor students go to get their study, to get their education, they are provided with a food, a meal, which is known as a midday meal scheme. The positive effect of midday meal schemes were more children have become enrolling. Now, as we know, in these government schools, all the poor children come to seek for education. Now, because they now knew about it, now there will be food provided in the school and they will be given at least one time of meal. So they became fascinated to this scheme and more students started enrolling in the school. Second, attendance became regular. Earlier, this was a complaint of the teachers that after lunchtime, whenever lunchtime starts, the students go back their home as they live in the nearby houses. So they go back their home and they never come back after having their lunch. And this was just 1.5 hour school, and then the studies gets over. Now, after this midday meal scheme, when the students got to know that they will be provided with the meal, attendance became regular and also students stopped going back to their houses for their food. Also, it reduced caste prejudices. Caste prejudices, earlier, I belong to Brahmin community, I will not touch your food. You belong to this community, you stay there, you sit there and don't have food with me. Such kind of practices were there actually in the schools. Now, they were asked to sit together on a mat. They have to share, they have to sit together and they have to have their lunch, and which was to be made by a Dalit woman. The Dalit women have been employed to cook the meal so that this discrimination of caste could be avoided.